Hello friends, so welcome back to part 3 of carcinosin. And what I'm going to tell you in this video is that you need to take medicine for yourself and you need to take homeopathic medicine for yourself if you want to find array of channels in your life whenever you feel blocked. Whenever you feel blocked, whenever you have any health issues or any even emotional disturbance also, you should take homeopathy for one major reason. That talking to a homeopath, or if you are a homeopath and you are not able to understand which remedy to take, talk to your friend or talk to anybody. What happens in talking is, what happens when you are putting words to your feelings is that you understand yourself better. And when you understand yourself better, you realize that where you are stuck, where you are blocked in life. And if you want to progress, you have to outgrow of those blockages. So when I was newly married and I was having certain family issues, I used to talk to my master, I used to talk to my colleagues, I used to talk to some people who are homeopaths. And after talking to them, they would tell me, you know, I had taken carcinosin once and it worked like miracle in my life. You know, I had fever and I was having long standing weakness and a lot of other issues. So then the advice that I got from those people was that Pallavi, you need to be selfish in life. You just cannot be selfless and keep doing and doing. And what about you? So what happens in carcinosin is that they let go of the power of themselves, power of their own life. The power that the person needs to keep in his or her own hands and not let go of. What happens in carcinosin is carcinosin gives his power, the power of his own life, to other people so that they dominate him and they make him do all those work which he doesn't like to do. You know, useful desire to be, why it is morbid? It is always good to be useful to others, but this is a morbidity to those people who are doing it overly. Anything which goes over, anything which goes out of limit is morbid. In carcinosin, it goes to the level of morbidity. He doesn't know where to keep those boundaries. He just breaks those boundaries and keeps on doing and doing and working for others. And with that smiling face, oh, you want this? I will give you this. You want that? What about your own needs? What about your own desires? What about your own basic satisfaction of life? You are not satisfying yourself, but only satisfying others becomes excessively useful to others and not providing that energy, that power, that kind of need to yourself first. You first give pleasure to yourself. So what happens in carcinosin? Delusion being a martyr. This is how they feel. So I would just go, there was a case of autism that I had mentioned in the seminar also, in the webinar that we had. So that boy, he's still doing very well, you know, in throughout the lockdown, he has been such a cooperative child, although there are tantrums and those things, but his destruction has gone down, his banging head over the wall and not able to understand. Now he's able to talk, you know, at the age of 7 years of age, he started babbling now and his parents are so happy. This happened after carcinosin 30 when I started just 4 months back. And after that, within a month's time, he would, a 7-year-old boy, he was not able to utter a single word from his mouth. He would just and nothing else. And now he started babbling. He started saying ba ba ma ma. And now even in last month, he's trying to make 2-letter words and he's doing it very well. That kind of progress has come. Otherwise, that kind of destruction, breaking things here and there. And you know, with all this destruction in carcinosin child, the essence of carcinosin is always there. That sensitivity, that when people around are not well, that people, his mother is weeping, then he becomes very sad. He becomes, oh mama, you know, the kind of expression that all destruction is shut for that time when others are not well around. So that sensitivity is there in a carcinosin child. Although he's that violent and throwing tantrums, but when others are not happy around him, he will be mild, he will be subdued, and then he will be dominated by others' emotions and he will be under control and he will also weep and he will also feel bad. So this was the combination in this boy. Okay, now there's another lady, and she has had, I'll tell you, she had had three operations of kidney stones. Three operation of kidney, big size stones she had. All three times she did operation. And after that, now the condition is that her renal cortex is left to minimum thinness, I would say. What thickness? The renal cortex has lost all its thickness, and all uric acid is high, and there are renal stones still hidden in her kidneys and ureters. And the pain she had, intolerable pain while passing urine, intolerable to control the urge of urination, such was her state that every half an hour she would have the urge, and once the urge is there, she can't stand for a minute without pain, a second without pain, I would say. And after starting with carcinosin, she's able to tolerate the sensation of wanting to pass urine. Her urine has become absolutely painless. So this is the change that is coming up now. She's become so relaxed mentally. She lives in a joint family where her husband is a little powerful, not dominating, but powerful. And her in-laws, both of them, they are very, very critical of her. And throughout the day, she's only wanting to satisfy them, wanting to keep them happy. They are so critical. When a person is hypercritical, you should not just keep on satisfying them. It is that tendency. Once you understand that this is a person's tendency, put a limit to yourself. Cut down. Just accept that they are like this. They are not going to change. Why should I just keep on exhausting myself? You know, carcinosin doesn't understand that thing, that he is wanting to satisfy others. And all the cases that have followed, and there I will tell you one small, all ladies, I have prescribed carcinosin on this format only, on not knowing the limitations of their own energies and how much efforts they are putting in. I will tell you one small boy again, because ladies, adults we can identify carcinosin very easily. I will tell you one boy and then again an adult. Okay, this boy, just 3 years of age, I was having clinic in a complex earlier. In that complex, I had to enter through the gate, walk through few buildings, and then my clinic used to be there earlier. So whenever I used to walk all across, I would see children playing around. And this boy, he used to be so shabby in his clothing, just wearing anything, short is here, short outside the pant and half tucked in, and no sense of, the mud is over here on his dresses, the typical ad of Surf Excel that is shown on TV. Very, very similar kind of attire he would have. And just bindas playing around. Bindas meaning not just wanting to bother about anything in the world. And then once he came for fever, and he had problem of bedwetting also. So I saw him in fever, and in the clinic also, he was just picking up things here and there, and mother is describing him, and he was so untidy, And this thing was on my mind, that this boy is really careless about how people think about him. He's just into his own world. And then his mother described that, I asked her, and he was very polite to me. Yes, auntie. Hello, auntie. How are you, auntie? Like this. And then mother described him that he's very sincere in his homework, and he had high fever. He wanted to go to school next day. So I was like, why you want to go to school? Just 3 years old, what homework? It's okay. No, my teacher will check my book. I was like, okay, so sincere. So teacher wants to check his book and he wants to complete. And he's like, whenever he comes from school, the first thing is he will open his book, he will complete his work, and then keep the book, bag, everything in place. And about his shoes and other things, I was trying to confirm. So she's like, he will do that, but in his own pace. I don't have to, I should not keep on enforcing myself, but he will do it on his own. He will keep his things in place, his toys in place. But otherwise, if people are coming, some guests are expected or something, then he will do quickly. But if nothing is there, he's in no hurry, he will do it आराम से, बट इफ आई टेल हिज सिस्टर शी वुड नॉट डू एट ऑल, बट एटलीस्ट ही डज इट. सो आई हैड गिवन हिम कार्सिनोसिन एंड वन रिएक्शन ऑफ कार्सिनोसिन आई वुड से आफ्टर गिविंग द मेडिसिन दे जनरली टेंड टू गेट फीवर. And he got high fever spike once after the dose. He was better, then got a spike. I kept on SL only, just on Sac-Lac placebo. And then that spike also reduced. And then he was just fine. After that, his bedwetting also stopped completely. Now, another case of, quickly I will just sum up. This case was of a male. And he was a very, very, very sweet person. He had a wife and two daughters. And also a mother living with him. Now this mother was the stepmother, not actually stepmother, but we say kaki, means father's brother's wife. So father's brother and his wife, they had adopted him because his father had four sons. So they gave away, he was the eldest one, and they gave away him to this one brother of them. Now, he being actually, you know, he couldn't belong anywhere properly because they had adopted him, and this mother, actually the auntie, she was very, very critical and dominating over his wife. So, she would want his wife to do everything for her and still listen to all the blah, blah, blah that happens at homes. And then he wanted to keep his brothers and his own parents also happy and keep those cordial relations. Whenever they would go to village and they would meet them, he would take all gifts and everything. So, he was trying to keep everyone happy, and in the process, you know, a whole day a person goes from morning to night for work, and then after night he had to go through the quarrels of his wife and this aunt mother, and then he had to resolve their issues till night 12, 1, and then the sleep, and then again morning he had to explain to his wife that you be like this, you be polite, you be gentle, you just keep your mind cool, everything will settle down. He would explain to his mother, so that harmony he would try to maintain everywhere. And whenever this aunt used to complain about the daughter-in-law to village, then he had to give all the explanations to them also. So this was a very gentle person who's trying to maintain harmony everywhere. He would be very sweet to me also. He would be very sweet to everyone around. His general tendency, because I have seen him outside also. So with that smiling face, it looks fake at times. You know, carcinosin, so sweet that the sweetness starts looking fake at a point when you know that he is not really happy but just trying to show happy. So this is these are few cases that I wanted to highlight, the very very unique cases, and the case of cancer that I had shown. That man also, you know, entire life, from he gave up on his studies in fourth standard. Then he did construction laborer work. After that, he was appointed as a mason in a very good firm. And from there, he, after a few years, he gave some exam and then he became a clerk. And after becoming a clerk, he retired in that same company. All these years, he kept on supporting his family members, including his wife's brothers, including his own brothers, settling the children of every one of them. Whoever needs anything, you know, he's the person. And when I went and spoke to him, he has tears in his eyes, that who will live with you in your house. And he had those tears, that sensitivities of carcinosin, that who lives with him also makes him weepy. And there was a time when I actually understood that this is carcinosin. This is the softness that he holds, that attachment. This is the bond he feels, that what will happen to others after he dies. Because he has been the provider to all family members. So this was making him weepy, and he passed away so gently. Then another lady too, that was a hallmark case of my practice, where she had those she had bruised herself with the side effects of medicine and yet not blaming anybody. That is the kind of delusion wrong suffered that carcinosin expresses every time. So mild, so gentle. They will express that where they felt that they have suffered wrong, where others have been really unkind to them, really too many expectations, and that is the wrong suffered of carcinosin. But carcinosin never raises his voice against those people. He takes in because he's under their domination. He knows that they are elder to me and I am staying under them. So this is the kind, you know, they are related to me, they are my this, they are my that, and they give various explanations to satisfy themselves, actually, that no, because of so many reasons I can't say anything to them. If anybody shouts at them, they will not say. They can't say, they can't express themselves to those people who have hurt them. Carcinosin will never be able to retaliate or to react in an aggressive manner to people who have hurt them, and this is where we can catch carcinosin. So we will continue with the rubric journey of carcinosin in the next video. Thank you so much. Do like, comment and subscribe. Bye.